Hi students, we all belong to family. So, let us discuss about the family and certain important issues related to family. Title, Family Crisis, Parental Separation, Divorce, Alcoholism, Step-Parenting. India is a pluralistic and multi-ethnic society consisting of extremely complex family systems. The major dimensions of this complex organization are its structure and compositions, patterns of role relationships, dynamics of interaction, value systems, and family ethos. The past few decades have witnessed numerous influences on and changes within the Indian family system. The uncertainty and rapidly shifting climate of modern social, political, and economic life in India has rendered families vulnerable to a host of challenges and difficulties. More than ever before, families need to become better equipped to handle internal stresses and problems and confront external threats and demands. The range and variety of problems that Indian families face are developmental, and everyday problems faced by all families at one time or another. The need for understanding family problems has been emphasized in order to prepare family members to face these problems successfully so that they can have healthy and satisfying life. By learning this lesson, one can understand all the problems faced by the Indian families, which is also known as crisis in general. Learn the lessons and remedial measures for the crisis such as parental separation, divorce, alcoholism, and step-parenting. What is family crisis? A crisis is an incident or problem occurs all of a sudden for which there is no immediate problem. It is something that make one strive for a different and unusual solution. Family living is a constant process from day to day, week to week, and year to year. It is simply meant only when family members fail to do their share in making the business of home living easy and smooth. When difficulty arises in the family, it is no cause for alarm. On the other hand, conflicts that occur too frequently and that never seem to get worked out are matters for concern. At times, every person is irritated and irritating, thoughtless and discontinuous. Families in the contemporary society accept the challenge that intimacy and constancy are necessary for a satisfying and happy life. Each family is unique in its style of living and in the problems it faces. While some characteristics of the family are fundamental, many changes as the family unit deals with challenges at different developmental stages. When the changes are sudden, causing disorganization and disruption in the structure of family, or it can be said that the family is in crisis. Crises are sometimes of instability, necessitating problem-solving skills, decision-making, and adjustment. Sometimes the problems develop because of events outside the family. For example, natural calamities such as hurricane, earthquake, flood war, national economic depression, or closing of a plant where family members work. At other times, the problems occur within family system. due to the loss of family member, conflict that erupts in family violence, divorce or alcoholism, internal problems or crisis tend to demoralize a family, increasing resentment, alienation and conflict. Sometimes a crisis develops out of whole series of small internal and the external events that build up to the point where family members cannot cope up with the series of events. Some examples are unwanted pregnancy, shifting to a new place, financial problems due to the closing of industrial sites, heavy debt which is unable to clear, accidents, runaway situations, infidelity, alcoholism, drug abuse, death, divorce, family violence, child spouse abuse, sexual abuse, extramarital relationship, economic distress, conflict in marriages, single parent families, victimization and childlessness. Thus, any rupturing of family relationships which forces reorganization of the family pattern not only constitutes a family crisis but also is a threat to family unit. All these events, problems can be categorized under demoralization, dismemberment, separation, distortion in quality of parenting. Types of family crisis in different stages of life. Let us take first the married couple stage, infidelity. Adults involved in extramarital affairs due to ambivalence about marriage, seeking pleasure and excitement, permissive values, ulterior motives and the need to build one's ego. In-law problems, divorce, spouse abuse, wife abuse, that is violence against women, sexual abuse, marital, rape, teasing, molestation and indecent representation, childlessness. Conflict in relationship in the areas of money management, discipline of children, personalities, habits, sexual relationship and physical or verbal violence. The next stage is childbearing and rearing stage. Role conflicts occurs when the demands of one role interferes with another role. Feeling neglectful, not realizing the expectations of others, fighting for internalized norms, making time of kin and friends. Role overload, dual earner family members in the family with young children are burdened by role overload. Illness, families with young children and with aging members go through bouts of sickness more often. Transition to parenthood, the birth of the first child is a crisis in that it calls for reorganization of the family. Hence, parenthood is a critical experience and that marital satisfaction drops sharply with the birth of the first child. Child marriage, the practice of child marriage is another example of child abuse. In rural areas, child marriage is common. Child brides frequently suffer ill treatment from their in-laws. Sibling violence, battering a sibling is a form of violence that is granted a high degree of tolerance. Physical violence among siblings may result in suicide of the victim, imprisonment or institutionalization of the perpetrator or runaway situation of the victim. Violence of any kind brings down the family's status. Hospitalization. People are hospitalized due to accidents, illness or bad injuries. It is very stressful time for the family members. During such time, the patient and family members must live through a continuing period of acute crisis. Next, school going stage. Child abuse is most important crisis, which includes physical assaults, malnourishment, abandonment, neglect, and emotional or sexual abuse. The causes for sexual abuse are lack of social and emotional maturity of parents, broken homes or divorced parents, poverty, workloads in large families, children with physical or mental defects, authoritarian parents, personality problems in parents, economic stress, stress associated with premature child, lack of supportive network of family. A child who is unusually aggressive, disabled, slow learner, teenage pregnancy and parenthood, alcoholism and drug abuse, and related psychological problems. Now, let us see what are all the crises in adolescence stage. Sexual abuse, adolescent-parent conflict, alcoholism, illegitimacy, runaway situation, drug abuse, suicide, homicide, step-parents, disgrace, and economic distress. Now, what would happen during the middle age stage, empty nest period? When all the children leave the home, the parents are left alone again, widowhood. Children leaving home for their own job or settle in marriage, hence parents are left alone. Old age stage. It's very pathetic stage. Health problems would occur more. Retirement is another crisis. Financial problems, elder abuse, searching for re-employment, bereavement, death of the spouse, single parent mother, father, economic distress, desertion, drug abuse. Now, family crisis, its effects, coping strategies, and what are the possible prevention? Common conflict management styles in marriages are avoidance of sulking behavior, avoiding an issue keeping yourself, avoiding joking around and teasing, seeking new way to settle the disagreement, seeking an outsider to act as a mediator to settle the conflict. Divorce requires family life education, premarital counseling, marriage enrichment program, temporary separation, marriage and family therapy. Now, what can we do for alcoholism? Wives have to use a variety of strategies to help the alcoholic. Act normal or natural, like nothing is wrong. Take overall household responsibilities in the hope that an extremely pleasant, burden-free atmosphere will reduce the husband need to drink. Select non-drinking companions or visitors for social occasions. Money to be restricted. Keep the husband busy with a variety of hobbies. Seek the professional assistance. Now, what is infidelity? What can be done for infidelity? The lines of communication must be open in the marriage relationship. Strive to fulfill one another's physical, social, emotional and intellectual needs through the relationship. Show respect, appreciation, approval, acceptance of one's spouse. Commit to sexual fidelity. Avoid heterosexual or extramarital situations. What can be done for economic distress, income loss and the economic strain are negatively associated with marital quality and family satisfaction related to financial conflicts. the psychological instability of family members, marital tensions and hostility. A more positive approach is to cut expenditure whenever possible and to postpone major expenditure. Selling property or possessions is sometimes necessary. Taking a second job in addition to one's primary job may to help ease the financial burden. Runaway and imprisonment. Family counseling centers play an important role in the prevention or treatment of all social evils. In the case of runaway children, they may be admitted in a juvenile home where they may be provided with primary education and counseling. Childlessness. Various people have negative attitude towards the couple who are childless. Wives are stigmatized. Adoption and artificial insemination can improve family relationships, providing a childless couple. Child abuse. Family life and parenthood educational programs for parents or couples in schools, churches, or community organizations about realistic expectations of children's behavior and development at different stages. Desertion. Providing therapy to improve attitudes and adjustments for the spouse. Loss of a child. Retirement. Suicide. Widowhood. Hospitalization of a child. Now, drug abuse. Primary preventive education activities to strengthen family life. Secondary prevention involves early diagnosis and treatment, counseling services to young people. Tertiary prevention includes the establishment of linkages with treatment and rehabilitation centers. Parents can help by giving unconditional emotional and physical support to their child. Sexual abuse. Moral and sexual education should be made compulsory in schools and colleges. Pornographic literature and blue films should be banned. Sexual predators should be treated using psychological or medical techniques. Separate courts should be constituted for cases of sexual abuse. Awareness on sexual abuse could be created through mass media. School officials and teachers should learn about signs and symptoms of childhood sexual abuse for identification purpose. Now, let us see one of the important family crises, parental separation. Parental separation can be considered in two ways. Parents, father, mother separation leading to single parent family, and secondly, children separated from parents. Father mother separation. A family in which father mother may be separated for a longer duration due to job or due to divorce. In such cases, children may live with single parent. If it is due to the job of the father, the child may live with the mother in woman headed family. In such type of families, children live under the guidance of the mother. Fatherlessness at home may lack the guidance in day-to-day life and no role model for the male children. Children from women headed families may be affected in their academic activities, games and sports. In case if the mother remarries, there would be distortion in quality of mothering. Similarly, if the child is living with father, because of the mother's death, ill health, divorce or remarriage of the mother, children live with the father. Such families, father's absence at home is longer, no proper care to children, fulfillment of the needs may be affected, no role model for the girl children. Children have to take up the family responsibility. Hence, the children's studies may be affected. The condition of children would be worse if the father marries another girl. The stepchild-stepmother relationship would be miserable in most of the cases. Children separated from parents. Children are separated from both the parents or anyone, maybe because of all the following reasons: death of the parents, temporary separation, multiple parenting, distortion in quality of parenting. Death of the parents. Children are left alone due to the death of the parents, maybe because of illness or accident. Children may live with grandparents, aunts or uncles, stay in a hostel or in an orphanage. Temporary separation. Children may be separated from parents temporarily in the case of parents' work outside the residing area, illness, residing in the hostel for the sake of good education, aimed which is far off place. Multiple parenting. Children reared by many other relatives such as grandparents, aunts, uncles, caretakers, in addition to mother. In this situation, children are reared by many on their own styles. Hence, children may be confused to which role model to be followed, ultimately ends with stress. In addition, adults may show different attitude and practice for their children and these children, which leads to the feeling of insecurity. Distortion in the quality of parenting. Children born too early, prior to the planning of the young couples who spend money and time on establishing the household. Only boy among many girls, only girl among many boys, stepchild and disabled children are read in a different way. Maybe rejection attitude or authoritarian style of child rearing are common. In such a situation, children do not feel happy and contented at home. Effects of parental separation on children. Children's needs are not fulfilled. No proper role model to follow. No proper guidance for the right path. Children's rights are not met. Poor health condition. Inadequate feeding. No proper schooling. In some cases, child labor excess, poor academic progress, lack of concentration, memory power, feeling of inferiority complex and insecurity. Children become rebellious or timid, no involvement in play, creativity. Anyhow, the effect may vary from family to family. Divorce. Legal separation of the couple permanently is known as divorce. Causes and effects of divorce vary from individual to individual, family to family, community to community, and areas. The number of divorce cases are increasing in an alarming way year to year. Causes: lack of adjustments between the couple, in-law problems, dowry, childlessness, status of the family in both sides, infidelity of the spouse, premarital relationship, inferiority complex among the spouse, sexual abuse, patriarchal system, nature of the job. Now, what would be its effects? Effects on husband, wife and children are different. Children are more affected because of the verdict of the court to stay with either of the parents. If the child is with the mother, father's affection, guidance and role model may not be there. Mainly children would be affected in their studies. Financial problem may crop up. If the child is with the father, maternal care, affection, nurturance may be missing. If remarried, stepmother problem will be there. In both the cases, children have to shoulder lot of responsibilities both inside and outside the home. Child abuse, sexual abuse, child labor, and unable to enjoy the child's rights are some of the common problems seen among children. Measures to be adopted to overcome this. Family life education to parents, premarital and postmarital counseling, marriage enrichment program, trials separation, marriage and family therapy, premarital dating to understand each other. Now, alcoholism is also another crisis which you all know in day-to-day life. Alcoholism creates a family crisis because the disease affects the whole family. Like the alcoholic, family members also go through various stages as they attempt to cope with the crisis. What are its causes? Why do they drink? Bad companionship, pleasure-seeking attitude, initially enjoyment and become an addict, family problems, personal problems, joblessness. Effects. Effects depend on who is the alcoholic, father or son or mother, and what is the economic status. If the father is the alcoholic, children would be more affected, that too if there is financial insecurity, excess. Children may be adopting this bad habit. Education may not be completed. Insecurity among the family members may prevail. Family responsibilities may be shouldered by the mother heavily. So what measures can be taken to come out of this crisis? Counseling to be given, family life education to be strengthened, good understanding among family members to be established, job opportunities to be found out. Now, another important crisis taking place in modern families, step parenting. In the case of the death of the parents, separation of the parents, chronic illness of any one of the parent, and divorce of the parents, remarriage take place, in which families step parenting process is on. It is needless to mention that it is the weakness of the parents to treat the children of the previous mother in a lower status. This kind of attitude is known as distortion in quality of parenting, such as authoritarian style of parenting, in which parents are dominant, orders children, no freedom, unfulfillment of needs, verbal abuse, physical abuse, denial of child's rights, lack of love and affection, expectation of too much of perfection, and punishment for wrongdoings. Children reared by this technique used to be very rebellious or submissive, and the expectation of such behavior from others. To conclude, problems within a family unit affect all members. Families with problems have certain needs, require specific coping skills, and therefore may be considered high-risk families. When couples have strained relationships, children feel the effects even when parents try to hide the conflict. In the same way, chronic illness, disability in a family member, unemployment, divorce, or death, or any other family problems disturb the whole family system, potentially affecting both the physical and mental health of all family members. Family intervention, family life education, family counseling, and family therapy to be provided in a holistic approach to avoid family crisis and to lead a happy and contented life.